Huge announcement. ChatGPT now has a search option. With ChatGPT, now you can search the web, and it's so huge advantage. It's just like Perplexity. Let me show you something about Perplexity. Let me search my name, Philippe. Right. So all the information about me will come. So the system goes search information to the web and summarize everything here and also give you the link. ChatGPT can do the same. Now, let's go there. You can see here that when you go to ChatGPT 4.0, here you can see that there's a search function here. So let me search my name, Philippe. So it searched the web and it gives me all the information about myself. And then, so this is my website. You can go there. So it's so easy. If you want to know more about somebody, you just search for the person, especially when you want to interview the person, get some background information. It's always important to do some research, and this function will be so helpful. You can easily click on the links there that has been provided. It doesn't only summarize the information for you, it gives you the links similar to Perplexity, right? When you click on sources here, it shows you on the right side all the website that you can go in connection to the information that has been provided. That is very good, right? So let's go further. So let me do another search, thematic analysis. Let's say you want to know more about thematic analysis, and then you want a system to search the web, right? You type thematic analysis, it will not go and search the web. It just give you information directly about what thematic analysis is all about. So now the strategy is always tell the system that it should search the web, right? Whenever you want the system to search the web, you have to tell the system. So now I can say that you can say search and thematic analysis, right? Just doing that, you are prompting the system to search the web. And then it will be able to search the web and get all the information that you need about thematic analysis. And not only that, it provides you the link to resources, right? So as you can see, you can click on this link and search for more information. Another thing is that you can be more specific and say, can you provide me articles about thematic analysis, right? And the system will be able to search the web and to be able to provide information. You can click on some, and then you'll be able to get articles. You'll be able to easily get online articles related to the topic or the information that you are searching for. Let's say you want an article about, search for articles about mental health Sigma. It's so fast too, right? You see, it's searched the web. It gives you all the information about mental health. You can click on the link and it take you to an article related to that. If you want research articles, you can be more specific. We can go back, you go to edit, and then instead of search for articles, you can say search for research articles and click on send. Perfect. It will be able to, look for articles. And let's click on this one and see. So we see how it will take you to a specific article related to your topic. This is a game changer. You can search for information, it can give you a summary of the source and then provide you the source. And this will make your research so easy. You just click on that and you get access to the article. Be clear about your prompt. Clearly ask the system to search if you want it to search the internet. So that's very helpful. Imagine that you have analyzed your data, right? Let me see what I can find some data, and then let me select all of them. So imagine you have a data, you have uploaded it about interviews. Let's take one of the research question here, right? And then ask the system to generate themes based on the research question that you have. And then I put the research question here. And so let's see what we're going to get. The system is reading. Now it has provided themes explain what the themes are and also give the source of the participant that are connected to a specific team. So that is very good. And imagine that you want the system to search online and give you information that are consistent or related to the themes, right? Can you search for scholarly articles related to the themes you have provided? So this one is going to be helpful when you are discussing your finding. You want to compare and contrast the findings, the literature. So you just want the system to search for literature, and then you can use some of the literature to write your discussion. So the system is searching the web, and you see it has quickly provided information on your right side about the website. Wow. So you see how for each of the themes, you have resources online to help you to compare and contrast with what you have, right? So that is amazing. It will make doing research so easy. So here too, and click on that to take you to an article related to the theme. Wow. Can you create a table showing the themes? Great. Information about the articles, themes, and links to the articles. Yes, so it has created a table and showing you the themes and a brief description about the article and the link. This is amazing. This will really help you in terms of discussing what you found. What articles are related to your topic? What articles are related to your findings? What articles are even related to the decision that you make in your study? Let's say your methodology. Maybe you chose a case study. You can ask the system to give you articles related to case study so that you'll be able to write about it. Maybe the number of participants. Can you provide me research articles that will help me defend the number of participants for my phenomenological study? And you can search the web. Qualitative research link here gives you information about the sample size and saturation. And this is good. Just asking the system to find articles for you is the only step. And then you can get rich information to help you to do your research from the beginning to the end. Even think about your topic, right? Let's say you have an idea about your topic, you can ask the system to search the web and give you articles related to the topic. You can ask the system to search a web to give you information about the methodology. You can ask the system to search a web to give information related to your findings. So this is what I have for you. You can try it out when you go to ChatGPT website. I don't know whether this one is also available for the free version, but I'm using a paid version, so I have access now. So try it and let me see what your thoughts are and also some of the best practices that you can share. Thank you so much for your time.